Manchester City have broken the British transfer record to sign Villa captain Jack Grealish. He's joined on a six-year deal for a fee of £100 million to end a 19-year stay at Villa Park. But how has this deal come about? Aston Villa chief executive Christian Purslow addressed supporters with a live broadcast on Villa TV.
Last summer, following interest from a number of clubs, we offered Jack a new contract to stay at the club, which he accepted with one proviso. Jack wanted to be certain that if at any point a Champions League club came in for him and Aston Villa was not in that competition, that we would not stand in his way. For that reason, we agreed to incorporate a so-called release clause into his contract. Our board set this clause at a value of £100 million, knowing that would be, by some way, a record price for a British footballer and also a record fee for any player bought by a Premier League club. Put another way, we set the value at a level we hoped would not be met, but which would reflect his truly unique value to Aston Villa. After a brilliant season for Jack, culminating in his performances at the Euros, a number of clubs expressed interest in signing him, initially at figures below the release clause. We simply refused to entertain those approaches. Finally, Manchester City notified us that they would be willing to pay the £100 million it would take to trigger this clause. After many hours of discussions involving Jack, his family and his agent, during which we made clear our strong desire for him to stay at Aston Villa, Jack finally decided that he would like to go to City and instructed us to exercise his release clause, as was his prerogative. As we now near the start of the season, Dean and his coaching staff, our players and the board are all looking forward to seeing our new team with enthusiasm, with excitement, and with confidence. There is real depth and breadth to our squad with these new players and the returning Ashley Young, joining last year's outstanding signings, all of whom have settled brilliantly, as well as some more very high potential academy graduates who are now in and around the first team squad. They truly are the future. On behalf of Nassef, Wes and myself, we really look forward to seeing you all back at Villa Park on August the 21st. And thank you for your fantastic support.
Villa Chief Executive Christian Purslow there. It's when you lose your best player, it's always a bit of a... even though you're expecting it, aren't you? Where do you think... we'll talk about Villa later, Cass, but where do you think Jack's going to play? Is he an immediate starter? Because Pep doesn't care who you are, you know?
Well, he's had a number of wide left and right players out, haven't he?
Foden's been out there, hasn't he?
You can go Foden, you can go Bernardo Silva, you can go Mahrez on the right, you can have Raheem on the left.
Because Mahrez was great last year, wasn't
he? Second part of the season was fantastic, Al. Look, it's a difficult one for... I think he's going to have to become a more versatile player, Jack. And look, Gareth Southgate clearly saw him only in the left side of the midfield, which Dean Smith, 99.9% of the time, played him as well. I think he'll have a bit more versatility with going City because... You know, they play false number nines, as everybody know, and everybody can play on different sides. I mean, I've seen Sterling go on the right and I've seen obviously play more often on the left. Jack's got a challenge in front of him of a manager that's going to... I think without the ball, he's got to do a bit more. I mean, Pep, I would imagine, is thinking he's a £100 million player and you think he's got everything. Well, I think I can improve him. He had Iniesta, he had Xavi, people who keep the ball. Jack can keep the ball for fun. So I think there'll be room for improvement without the ball because that's what City do.
It seems that, you know, when you mentioned about the false number nine, people think De Bruyne will sit there. But De Bruyne, he's brilliant like Jack all over the pitch, isn't he, De Bruyne? So they will interchange, won't they? Jack can play up there, hold it up, get free kicks.
He's played about five different false number nines. Bernardo Silva's played it. Mahrez has played it. De Bruyne has played it. Foden's had the odd game there. you know, that's what Pep does. I remember doing an article last year talking about, you know, do they really need a centre forward? Because they very rarely have the same person that's going to do that role, because Aguero hardly plays.
So you could get your calculator and say, hold on a minute, they've not won the Champions League. He spent a billion.
Yeah, but they've been pretty successful. I think they've got a fantastic squad of players. They've won a lot of trophies. Incidentally, Al, I've got a little bit of trivia for you. Can you remember in 1979 who City broke the record fee for?
Daly? And,
yeah, Steve Daly. Who was the manager of Man City at that
in
time?
In 79? Don't tell me.
I'm not.
I was going to say, I might be miles away. I think you'll get it. Malcolm Allison.
Oh, good shout, Al. Yeah, in 1979, they bought Steve Daly for $1.4 million
from Wolves.
Yeah, you'd know him. I remember as a teenager watching him. That didn't work out. He left a few years late for $300,000.
Cass, I just have to look at my production side. Why are you flabbergasted I got that? Do you know what I mean? The thing I can't remember yesterday.
Well,
that was my era, that's why.
I tell you what it does do, Al. I mean, I've got to just add on, and we'll talk about a little bit about Villa, but I thought Christian Purslow's interview there was fantastic for the Villa fans.
I like Christian. He's been in there a few times.
Transparency for the fans to understand exactly how the deal come about, how they had no really way of negotiating. It was a deal that they met the asking price. And look, and they have done great business. Buendia, Bailey, and obviously Danny Ings coming in. Three great transfers for them that give them a little bit more, I think, again, all-round goals. I think they're looking at a bit of everything for them three. So fair play to him coming out and explaining to the Villa fans.
I wonder how Rupert Bell, our celebrity Villa fan, feels about Christian now. By the way, I'm going to have a word.
How could you not look at that and just think, wish our club would do that? Give so much explanation around a transfer. That's fantastic. Yeah, that's what Villa fans want.
We don't tell the fans enough. Dead right.
Well, Al, they come away from that feeling, yes, we've lost a great player, thank you very much, but they'll come away thinking how positive, from what they've just heard Christian Purslow say, that it's...
I hope the Villa fans as well feel, not when Villa play City, but, you know, I hope he doesn't get stick.
He won't. I don't believe that. No, I've always said, Al, the Villa fans were the nicest fans I ever played for. Now, it might be different now, but back in 1990 when I joined Villa, I couldn't believe. I went from Millwall, which could be pretty brutal to their players, to Villa, and it was like a shock to me. I remember thinking how nice they were. Millwall were great, as in the way they were, the fans, but the Villa fans were the nicest fans I ever played for.
TalkSport Breakfast with Alan Brazil. Thursday and Friday morning, 6 till 10. On AM, on DAB, via the TalkSport app, and on your smart speaker. TalkSport.